Let us move to another question, which is, if selling price of 950 gram of sugar is same as cost price of 1 kg of sugar, find profit or loss percentage. Now, it's already given that we are talking about SP of 950 gram and CP of 1 kg sugar, and what is being said is that CP of 1 kg is of sugar is equal to SP of 950 gram. Let us make them equal to X. Right. So now we have to find the profit or loss percentage. We do not know that whether we are having profit or loss percentage. First, let us see we are having profit or loss. If CP of 1 kg is X, then it obviously means that CP of 950 gram is less than X, right? Since the CP of 950 gram is less than X, that means CP of 950 gram is less than SP of 950 gram. That means we are having profit, because CP of 950 gram is less than X, or CP of 950 gram is less than SP of 950 gram, because SP of 950 gram is X. So that means I am having profit. I have to calculate profit percentage, right? Now, how do we calculate profit percentage? Like I told you in the previous question, that we always consider the same quantity, same amount in both SP and CP. So either we have to make this as 950 gram or either we have to make this 1 kg. What I mean is that if CP of 1 kg is equal to X, then what is the CP of 950 gram? That means if CP of 1 kg, can I write this as 1000 gram is equal to X, then CP of 1 gram with the help of unitary method is X by 1000, and CP of 950 gram is X by 1000 into 950, which is, and this turns out to be 95x by 100, which is, if you divide by 5 it becomes 20 and it is 19, which is 19x by 20. Now CP of 950 gram is this, 19x by 20, and SP of 950 gram is X. So can we find out the profit of in case of 950 gram? Profit, when we sell, when the shopkeeper sells 950 gram of sugar, is equal to SP of 950 gram minus CP of 950 gram, which is SP of 950 gram is X, and CP of 950 gram is 19x by 20. Now how do we separate this? As you know that we have to make the denominator same. Here the denominator is 1, here 20. Find out the LCM. LCM of 1 and 20 is 20. Now we have to make this one as 20. This is done by multiplying with 20, and this is also done with multiplying. We have to multiply both denominator and numerator with 20. So we have 20x minus 19x as X by 20. This is my profit. I have to find out the profit percentage, right? So the profit percentage is equal to profit, which is X divided by 20, divided by for CP of 950 gram. CP of 950 gram is 19X by 20. So it is 19X by 20 into 100. This actually means X by 20 divided by 19x by 20 into 100. I can write this as x by 20 multiply by, we have to invert this term, 20 by 19x. 20 cancels with this, also we have to place this 100. 20 cancels with this 20, x with this. So we have 100 by 19%. This is my profit percentage, which we were asked to find out. 100 by 19%. Now we can also do with another method, which is we can also find out SP of 1 kg. You'll see that the answer will come same, right? Let us do with that method, so that you can understand the funda, that whatever quantity you take, the percentage answer will always be same for every quantity. For example, that we have CP of 1 kg is equal to x. We have to find out SP of 1 kg, right? SP of 950 gram is x. SP of 1 gram is x by 950. SP of 1000 gram is x by 950 into 1000, which is 100x by 95. And I can write this as 520s are 519s, which is 20x by 19. Now, to find out the profit in case of 1000 gram or 1 kg, it'll be like SP of 1 kg minus CP of 1 kg. Now, SP of 1 kg is 20x by 19 and CP of 1 kg is x. Now again, take the LCM. We have LCM of 19 and 1 as 19. We'll write here 20x. Multiply the denominator and numerator with 19. We have minus 19x, which is x by 19. This is my profit, right? Now to calculate the profit percentage, let us do with black marker. Profit percentage is equal to profit, which is x by 19, divided by CP of 1 kg, which is x into 100. Right, this can be written as x by 19 divided with 19 into 100. Can I write this as x by 19 and inverting this second term as 1 by x into 100? X cancels with x. We have our answer as 100 by 19%. The very same answer which we did with the previous method. So the answer is 100 by 19%, which is same. Just remember that here both the quantities should be same. If it is 950 gram, here also it should be 950 gram. If it is 1 kg, here also it should be 1 kg. But the answer will always remain, because the percentage profit does not depend upon the quantity unless and until the CP and SP are same. Right? Let us see the second question. If the CP of three articles is same and shopkeeper makes profit of 10% on first article, loss of 3% on second and 9% loss on third, find overall profit or loss. It's a very simple question. CP of three articles is same. We do not know what is the CP, but we know that the CP is same. So let us assume the X. CP of one article is x, that means CP of three articles will be x plus x plus x, or 3 into x is equal to 3x, right? Now, shopkeeper makes profit of 10% on first, right? That means SP of first is equal to 10% profit means 110% of X, because this is my CP, right? That means 110 divided by 100 into X. That means 1.1x, because it is 11 by 10, which is equal to 1.1x. SP of second. He says that he makes a loss of 3% on second. That means 100 minus 3, 97. That means it is actually equal to 97% of X, because CP of second article is also X. So that means 97 by 100 into X, that is 0.97x. And SP of third article? Of third, he says that he makes a loss of 9%. That means 100 minus 9 is 91%. That means 91 by 100 into X is 0.91x. Right? CP of three articles was 3x. Therefore, total SP of three articles, because SP is different in each case, so we'll add all of them. Articles is equal to 1.1x plus 0.97x plus 0.91x. If you calculate, this would come out to be 1.1x plus 1.8, that means 1.88x, which is 2.98x. So we are asked to find the overall profit or loss, right? First, let us see, we are having a profit. We are asked to find out overall profit or percentage, right? For overall profit, we have to compare CP of three articles with SP of three articles. Now, CP of three articles is 3x and SP of three articles is 2.98x. Which is greater? Obviously, CP is greater. That means we are having the loss. We are having loss, right? How much loss are we having is, you can calculate over here that loss percentage, as you know, is equal to loss divided by CP into 100. Loss is CP minus SP. CP minus SP means 3x minus 2.98x divided by 100. Divided by CP. CP is 3x. Now, I am rubbing this part into 100. 3x minus 2.98x is 0.02x divided by 3x into 100. That means if you remove this decimal, we'll have 2x divided by 3x into 100. Because we remove this decimal, we are having two digits after decimal. So we wrote 100 over here and this 100 over here. 100 gets cancelled with 100 and x with x. So the answer is 2.3% loss. So in this transaction, when we are selling three items, right, each with different SP, overall we are having 2/3% loss. Now let us do the third question. In this case, CP was equal, and in this question, in third question, if you see, if you look, it's written if SP of two articles is same. So in this case, we are, first of all, we are considering two articles, and secondly, the SP is same instead of their CP, right? Now let us assume that SP of each article is X, because SP is same. So SP of two articles is x plus x, which is 2x. Right? Now, shopkeeper makes profit of 25% on first, loss of 20% on second. Right. Now, SP is same. That means one thing which is different in this case of both the articles is their cost price. We'll have to find out the cost, individual cost price, and then again, like we did in this question, we'll have to compare CP of two articles, overall CP, total CP and total SP, and then we'll have to see whether we are having profit or loss. Let us see CP of first article. CP of first article, you know that he is making a profit of 25% on first article. That means, can I write this as CP of first article? I am writing in subscript, or sorry, SP of first article is equal to making a profit of 25%. That means 125% of CP, right? Now we'll have to assume something CP, right? We have already assumed SP of each article is X. So let us make a change in this question. Let us assume that CP of first article is X. And instead of X over here, let us write it as 100. Right? Because I don't want to confuse you with two variables. So if I would have taken SP of each article as Y, and here also if I have taken X, then that would confuse you. So let us take SP of each article as 100 and this as 200. SP of first is 100 is equal to 125% means 125 by 100 of X. Right? 25 fives are 125 and 25 fours is this. That means, implies 100 is equal to 5X by 4. Right? That means if you calculate X, X is equal to this term will invert and it will become 4 by 5. 520 is 100. That means if SP of first article is 100, then CP of first article is rupees 80. Similarly, let us find out what is CP of second article. CP of second article. CP of second article is, in this case, we are having 20% loss. So that means SP of second is equal to 80% because we are having 20% loss of Y. Because here we'll have different cost price. That becomes 80 by 100 into Y. Here SP is same, which is 100. If we cut this 0 with this, and we have 2 4s are 8, 2 5s are 10, implies, let us take 4 by 5 over that, it becomes 100 into 5 by 4 is equal to Y. Right, now cut this with this, 4 25s are, implies Y is equal to 125 rupees. That means cost price of second article is 125 rupees. Now, can I say that total cost price is 80 plus 125? If we do 80 plus 125, it comes out to be CP of two articles, total CP, that comes out to be rupees 25, and total SP was rupees 200. Which is greater? This is greater. CP is greater than SP. That means we are having a loss of rupees 5. Now if we calculate in terms of percentage, we'll have loss percentage as equal to CP minus SP divided by CP. CP is, total CP is 205, and loss is CP minus SP, which is 205 minus 200, which is 5 into 100. Now can I write this as 5, can I cut this as 5 ones are 5 and here 540 ones are 205. So we have 100 upon 41% loss. This is my overall loss.